Hello students, we are continuing with the discussions of army reorganization made by Balban. Reorganization was main priority was given by Balban. He thought that army was the main support of his power to strengthen his position or consolidation of his empire. There is need of a strong efficient army. Balban increased the number of soldiers and officers in the army. He paid good salaries, took personal interest in the recruitment, training, and also maintained discipline in the army. He did not engage in unnecessary military campaigns. Whichever the military campaign is necessary, he was planned properly and executed the military campaign in the regions of Northwestern Frontier or in the regions of Eastern Empire, Bengal, or in the regions of Central India. For beginning of Delhi Sultanate itself, there is a practice of giving jagirs to the soldiers, land grants. For the first time, Balban stopped payment of jagirs to the soldiers. He thought that if their jagirs were given to the soldiers, they were not concentrated on work of military activities. That is why he stopped payment of jagirs to the soldiers and he started payment of cash payments introduced by Balban for the first time under Delhi Sultanates. He ordered the separation of military department from finance department. Earlier, finance department and military department were works together. For the first time, Balban decided to separate of military and finance department. It was Diwan-e-Wazirat was placed under a different department of military officer known as Diwan-e-Araz or Ariz-e-Mamlak. The officer in charge of look after the administration of the military activities and finance department was separated from military department. Diwan-e-Ariz, he was the position of an officer to carry the work of military administration. The person named Imadul Mulk was appointed as a military officer. He was also given a prime responsibility of army administration. Balban stopped land grants even after retirement and given pension. Earlier, the soldiers were retired, their family members or relatives or the associates of that soldier was getting frequently pensions from the empire. He stopped pensions and after their retirement, they are not included as a part of army. Diwan-e-Ariz has also given a responsibility of recruitment of soldiers, paying salaries to the soldiers, food, clothing, shelter, equipment, training, and maintain discipline in the army was the prime responsibility of military officer Diwan-e-Araz. Balban personally was led many military campaigns, but he planned the military campaigns personally and kept secret till the day of operation. That made him that he was execute his military campaign properly without any interference of the military officer. Another attempt made by Balban, he did not centralize the army. He has allowed governors of the various provinces, nobles, ministers were allowed to their own army. They helped king during the time of military expedition. They helped king in the time of military campaign. That will help him to Balban to build a strong army in the empire. Balban army consisting of three wings, infantry, cavalry and elephantry. They were placed under efficient officers. They were well trained and well disciplined army was maintained by Balban. Many old forts were repaired and new forts were built. The foreign invasions were properly checked and forces were stationed in important frontier regions of Lahore, Sindh, Multan, Baluchistan, the regions of Dipalapura, Saman, Herat, and also the regions of Ghazni. He was appointed many Abyssinian soldiers to protect the empire from foreign invasions. Balban also taken strong measures to safeguard the northwestern frontier against Mongol invasions. These are the steps made by Balban's made army was one of the powerful instrument force to maintain his dignity or consolidation of the position of Delhi Empire. Next one, Balban as a master of justice. In order to win the confidence of the people, in order to win the confidence of the public, Balban administered justice with extreme impartiality. There is no bias was found in justice. Balban succeeded in providing justice to his subjects. Balban had a high sense of justice. He appointed chief qazis and qazis in different parts of the empire, and they were imparting justice both civil and criminal cases. Minaz-us-Siraj was one of the prominent writer or contemporary of Balban and also one of the chief qazi during the period of Balban. King, as usual, was the fountainhead of justice. We can say that the Supreme Court of Justice, highest court of appeal. The king was to be the final judgment. Professor Habibullah has rightly praised that the sense of justice of Balban and also quoted many instances of punishments of highly placed nobles as examples of upholding justice by Balban. Last achievement on the part of Balban, organization of spy system. The success of Balban's administration was largely due to an efficient spy system. He appointed spies to watch the activities of his governors, administrative officers, military, civil officers. Along with that, his own son's activities was also checked by Balban. The spies or intelligence department, they were directly appointed and expected to provide information on all important matters to the king. Spies had direct connected with the king and they had to report all important matters, all the activities of the empire to the king daily. Works of spy system. Balban's success in executing his despotic policies, not only because he could getting fairer information of the incident which was happened in different parts of the kingdom. He can succeeded in getting information before whatever the incident were happened in the happening in future in kingdom. The credit of smooth running of the government goes to spies who always discharge their duties honestly. Spies were reported all the activities, injustice as a result, crime was checked and innocent persons were protected. Bughra Khan's movement was also watched by the spies. No wonder that his prince contended himself with the governorship of Bengal. His own son, Bughra Khan, was also checked by king. The spy system was proved very harmful in checking many conspiracies. Barid was the officer in charge of spy department. Subordinate spies were helping in their works. Spies were paid handful good salaries but were required to work efficiently. Those who are failed to do justice to their work, they were dismissed and punished. As long as spy system, spy department was present, there is no problem in this empire. Finally, the spy department's presence demoralized the community and social effect on the society. Balban's efficient spy system worked well, and finally, it also create a problems of demoralization of the society and social evils. Thank you, students.